everybody. Welcome to This is Smart Architecture. My name is Peter. I'm here with Siba from Publicis Sapient. Good to have you here.
Thank you, Peter.
All right, Siba, so before we talk about the board, what do you guys do?
So Publicis Sapient has been helping our clients in all things digital for over 2 decades. We help our clients in their journey of digital business transformation.
All right, so I know you've built this pretty cool account generation engine, right? So tell me what the reason was to build this and talk me through how it works.
So technology is changing very fast. And in our journey to help our clients in their digital business transformation story, we need our engineers to be equipped with newer technologies, tools, and solutions. Mm. So we need our engineers to be learning and experimenting on those. And we need a platform for that.
All right, so we have to provide dedicated accounts to each of your engineers to test things out, right?
Right.
So how does this all work? Show me.
So the account creation process is fairly simple. We kept it very straightforward. We have a user portal through which the user submits an account provisioning request. Mm-hmm. The API gateway listens to the request and forwards it to a validate Lambda function. Mm-hmm. The validate Lambda function actually verifies a few information, like email, domain, so that you know the request is coming from within the organization.
All right.
Once it does that, it sends a notification to the user acknowledging that you know the request has been received, mm-hmm. and then forwards it to create Lambda function.
Mm-hmm,
the create function actually creates and provisions the account.
Okay, understood. So first and foremost, the validation part is interesting. You make sure that not everyone is allowed to create those accounts. Lambda being well integrated with API gateway, kind of like a first-class citizen in here, and you use SQS to continue the flow. Now the creation is interesting. What's happening right here?
So creation is where actually the account is provisioned.
Mm-hmm.
Now, in the create process, we identify the master account. We use a multi-master account strategy.
Mm-hmm.
We identify the least used algorithm to find the master account in which the child account needs to be created.
Mm-hmm.
We configure the account. We assign the account an organization unit and create budget alerts. And finally, send a notification to the user and share the credentials.
All right. So there's three things that I'm interested in. First of all, the kind of the governance of those accounts. You see organizations place a role in here.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have the budget control.
Yeah.
So what happens on the organization side?
So what we have taken advantage of organizations is that we have an active account and we have an inactive OU.
Mm-hmm.
Right? We have active OU and inactive OU. Active OU is where all the accounts are hosted.
Mm-hmm.
And all the policies on security and cost are enforced on active OU. Inactive OU is essentially a deny all service. When an account is not in use, it is in a deny OU.
All right, right? Okay.
So first we've looked around using IAM policies to manage the whole governance, but we were lucky that SCP was launched around the same time.
Sure.
And you know we took advantage of it so that we can centrally control and manage all the governance.
Perfect. Okay, so you were able to say which services are made available to your users eventually. One thing we have not talked about yet is the CloudFormation part. I assume it's part of the kind of blueprinting, right?
Yeah. So the create process actually uses CloudFormation to provision the account and create budget alerts and all of that. Within the SCP, we have restricted the services that user can use.
Yeah.
We have also limited the kind of instance types that user can use.
Mm.
For example, reserved instances are forbidden.
Mm.
We have also restricted marketplace AMIs, right?
Mm.
So all of this is done within the SAP.
Okay, perfect. So then the last part I've asked already, which is the budget control, right? At some stage, you probably want to limit the usage off service.
Yeah.
So what's going on here?
So we use budget alarms and SES to kind of manage the monitor the budget.
Mm-hmm.
We have configured alerts to at 50%, 70%, and 90% of usage.
Mm-hmm.
And once the user is continuously notified, once the user gets to 100% budget usage, his account is actually moved to the inactive OU that I referred earlier, where all services are denied. And you know, after a certain hours, you know, we completely nuke the account so that you know, we don't end up consuming
the budget. Okay, perfect. So you remove those accounts that are not.
Yes.
in use anymore. Okay, perfect. Siba, thank you very much for, you know, shedding light on how you use organizations and how you kind of, you know, implement budget control to make sure that accounts are not abused at some stage, right? So thank you very much for this.
Thank you.
And thank you for watching This is Marketecture.